Could we establish a base on Proxima Centauri? Since Yuri Gagarin became the first human being to orbit the Earth in 1961, interest in exploring outer space has grown exponentially. There are currently two space stations with which we have managed to have a permanent settlement of humans in space, and we hope that in the not-too-distant future, we will be able to build a base on the Moon. But how far could we go? Someday, hundreds or thousands of years from now, when we have developed technology to travel to the stars, could we build human settlements far from our planet, like a space base on the star Proxima Centauri? Would something like this be possible? Let's find out. The big challenge. When we think of human settlements far from Earth, we talk about a distant future, perhaps thousands of years. For this reason, we must assume that if humanity plans to build a permanent settlement or base on the closest star to our solar system, we already have the technology to go to such a distant place. If you would like to know how long a manned trip to Proxima Centauri would last and what that trip would be like, we invite you to watch this trilogy of videos where we address these issues. That being said, if the human race manages to develop technology for interstellar travel, could we also build a base on the star Proxima Centauri for a permanent human settlement? To resolve this doubt, we must consider all the problems that we will face. To begin with, it is most likely that if we wanted to establish a base on Proxima Centauri, we would do so on the exoplanet Proxima B, which could have the right conditions to house living beings. But it is not a guarantee that this exoplanet will be as supportive of us as our planet, Earth, is. Radiation. Proxima B orbits very close to its star, which means it receives a lot of radiation and is prone to solar flares. This could be detrimental to any life. Also, Proxima B's atmosphere has not yet been fully explored, which means we don't know if there is a breathable atmosphere and if it is possible to shield it from radiation. The radiation at Proxima B is one of the biggest challenges in establishing a space base there. The star's proximity to the planet means that Proxima B receives significant radiation, which could be detrimental to human health. Radiation can damage DNA and cells, which can cause disease and cancer. To protect the inhabitants from radiation at a base on Proxima B, adequate protective measures would be needed. One solution could be to build the base underground or under a thick layer of protective material. The material used to build the base should also be resistant to radiation, such as lead and other shielding materials. Additionally, advanced technology could be used to monitor radiation and alert base inhabitants to any increase in radiation exposure. Another solution would be to use magnetic shields to protect the base from radiation. Magnetic shields are currently used on the International Space Station to protect astronauts from solar radiation. These shields are created by generating a magnetic field around the base, which deflects high-energy radiation particles. If Proxima B has a magnetic field like Earth's, if it does, that would be the best news ever. But if it doesn't, we would have to create one artificially. A novel idea is the one raised by some NASA scientists for the case of Mars. During the 2050 Planetary Science Workshop in late February of 2017, NASA scientist Jim Green proposed launching a magnetic shield between the red planet and the Sun to protect it from high-energy solar particles. This shield will be located at the L1 Lagrange point, a relatively stable point between Mars and the Sun. This shield would consist of a powerful solar-powered electromagnet, which would use sunlight to produce electricity and induce a current in a giant coil, producing a magnetic field large enough to block all radiation coming from the Sun, except for sunlight. Unlike our planet, where the magnetic field completely covers the Earth, in the case of Mars, it would be enough to cover only the side that points to the Sun, since that is where the radiation comes from. The shield would allow the planet to restore its atmosphere, rapidly improving its habitability. Ultimately, suppose the exoplanet Proxima B has no magnetic field like Mars. In that case, the astronauts in charge of building the base could replicate this idea by placing a magnetic shield between Proxima B and Proxima Centauri to protect the planet from radiation and thus begin constructing the base. Establishing a base at Proxima B would require a comprehensive and collaborative approach to meet radiation challenges. Scientists and engineers would have to work together to develop innovative and effective solutions for radiation protection. With the right technology and approach, it is possible to overcome these challenges and establish a foundation on Proxima B that can withstand and thrive in the extreme conditions of space. To solve this problem, advanced technology in space transportation would be required. Although living beings cannot travel at high speeds, our technology can do so without problems. Perhaps if we can develop ships that reach speeds close to the speed of light, or at least reach a few percent of this speed, spaceships loaded with materials and equipment could be sent from Earth, which would reach Proxima Centauri in a few years, helping astronauts establish a base on Proxima B. Before terraforming, it is currently unknown if Proxima B could be a habitable planet or if it would be possible to terraform it given its external proximity to its star. But what is a fact is that it is possible or not to terraform it. First, you have to establish a base near it. Once the magnetic field is guaranteed, the next step would be the most obvious of all, the water. Without water, there is no life. And although the spaceships of the future will indeed have the most advanced technology for the reuse of water, if we want to establish a base on Proxima B, it will be necessary to find a way to increase the water supply, especially if it is required to do construction on the surface of the exoplanet. One option could be to search for water deposits directly on the surface of Proxima B or other nearby celestial bodies. While the amount of water found on these celestial bodies may be limited, technology could be developed to extract and purify the water found. Another option could be extracting water from the atmosphere of Proxima B. If the planet's atmosphere contains enough hydrogen or oxygen, technology could be developed to extract and purify it for human use. The best thing about this is that this technology already exists and could be implemented on a large scale on another planet. The possibility of sending water from Earth could also be considered, although this is the most unfeasible option since the cost of sending large amounts of water to space is enormous. We could opt for more innovative solutions, such as mining asteroids or comets which contain water in the form of ice. Although not a single asteroid or comet has ever been discovered in another solar system besides our own, if these objects exist in our solar system, they most likely exist in other solar systems, such as Proxima Centauri, only we have to find them. In a way, exocomets, exoasteroids, and exomoons are objects that have never been observed with any telescope, but whose existence is highly probable, since if they exist in our solar system, they could exist in others. Based on this idea, some works of fiction have shown the idea of exoplanets with moons, the most famous being the movie Avatar, where the movie takes place entirely on the exomoon Pandora, a natural satellite that orbits a gaseous exoplanet similar to Jupiter. Our technology does not allow us to observe these objects in other solar systems. Still, we do not rule out that perhaps one of these could orbit very close to Proxima B. And if so, it could be an excellent place to establish the first human extrasolar base there. Finally, we could also obtain the vital liquid by mixing hydrogen and oxygen atoms through nuclear fusion. However, this is much more difficult than simply producing water through the combustion of some hydrocarbon-rich fuels. Best possible scenario. So far, we have discussed the problems and difficulties that would arise if we wanted to build a base on Proxima Centauri. But what if the outlook is not so bad? We now know that the star Proxima Centauri periodically ejects bursts of radiation that could sweep the atmosphere of any nearby planet like Proxima B. However, if the planet has a strong enough magnetic field and a very dense atmosphere, that could be enough not only to be habitable but also to house living beings. Does Proxima B have a magnetic field? We don't know. Does it have an atmosphere? We don't know either. Has life? If the two previous questions are answered in the affirmative in the future, then the chances of finding life would be very high. If Proxima B had the conditions to develop life like on Earth, we wouldn't even have to worry about radiation or lack of water to settle down and try to adapt a world in which we were not born. The opposite case could also occur, in which Proxima B had neither a magnetic field, atmosphere, nor life. In that case, establishing a base may not be the best idea. The best thing for future astronauts would be to continue their journey to other stars friendlier to living beings, stars like ours that do not expel bursts of radiation every time, allowing the planets to develop water-rich atmospheres in which life can thrive. Suppose Proxima B turns out to be hell instead of paradise. In that case, we'll have to keep looking elsewhere for a green and blue planet like ours, where we can establish a base for the future inheritors of the human race, and give them a chance to have a life where they can start from scratch, without making the mistakes that we have made in the past with our planet. The search for a new planet in the universe to make a base is challenging and complex, but it is also one of humanity's most exciting and promising undertakings. As we continue to explore and learn more about our universe, we realize countless possibilities and opportunities to discover and colonize new worlds. However, we must also be aware of our challenges and risks on this journey. From lack of water and radiation to technological and environmental challenges, there are many obstacles we must overcome if we want to establish a sustainable base on another planet. But if there is one thing history has taught us, humanity can overcome the most challenging obstacles when we come together and work together towards a common goal. Human creativity and our spirit for excellence will eventually lead us to overcome the challenges of space exploration and find a new home in the universe. Ultimately, our search for a new planet is not just about finding a place to live, but about broadening our horizons, exploring the unknown, and pushing the boundaries of what is possible. So let's go ahead with an open mind and a spirit of adventure, and who knows what wonders we may meet along the way. This is how we end the series of three videos about the trip to Proxima Centauri. What other topic would you like us to make a trilogy about? Let us know your opinion in the comments.